wanted to set out for a gathering, but first he came upon Philip. Follow me, Jesus said to him. Now Philip was from Bethsaida, the same town as Andrew and Peter. Philip sought out Nathanael and told him, we have found the one Moses spoke of in the law, the prophet, to Jesus, son of David from Nazareth. Nathanael's response to that was, can anything come from Nazareth that is good? And Philip replied, come, see for yourself. When Jesus saw Nathanael coming toward him, he remarked, this man is a real Israelite. There is no guile in him. How do you know me? Nathanael asked him. I saw you under the fig tree. Rabbi, said Nathanael, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel. Jesus responded, do you believe just because I told you I saw you under the fig tree? You will see much greater things than that. He went on to tell them, I solemnly assure you, you shall see the sky open and the angels of God ascending and descending on the Son of Man. The Gospel of the Lord. Let us all see. Today is the first Friday of the Christmastide season. And Holy Mother the Church continues to explain to us the importance of growing in wisdom and in grace. Saint Thomas of Aquinas had given us one of the rules of how to grow in the spiritual life. This important rule states that we have to grow every day. That anyone who stops growing just for one day regresses, meaning to say it goes down. And so it is important that to continually improve in our spiritual life, we have to grow in wisdom and in grace, every day and every second of our lives. The opposite to the truth is that anyone who stops growing in wisdom and in grace, even for a second, will always regress, meaning to say, go down in the spiritual life. And of course, if we don't grow in grace and wisdom for days, or for weeks, or worse, for years, then we definitely will go down and down and down to be eventually condemned to the fires of hell. So the rule is very clear. You have to improve, to grow in grace and in wisdom. And we mention the fact that we grow in wisdom by knowing in deeper, in a deeper manner, the commandments and the teachings of Christ. The teachings and the commandments are very, very deep. There is so much to learn in them that there is no end in learning them and putting them into practice. So the more we learn the commandments of Christ and the teachings of Christ, the more we grow in wisdom. And the moment we have the wisdom, we should put that into practice. And when we put it into practice, we gain more and more graces from God. Until we become more or less like the Blessed Virgin Mary, who was the seed of wisdom, because she knew so well, and at the same time, full of grace. Now, to make things easier for you to understand, let us ask the question, in what are we supposed to grow every day, every minute, every second? We must grow in our intellectual knowledge on how to love our neighbor. And this has been described to us by St. Paul in his epistle to the Romans, in the chapter that is entitled, What is Love? What is Charity? In fact, in the rule of Saint Benedict, that very short chapter is supposed to be memorized by everybody. Because when you memorize it, then the description of charity is in your mind. It is permanently in your mind, in your intellect, when you have memorized it, and therefore it is equivalent to you growing in knowledge of the command of Christ on how to love God and your neighbor. And as the first reading says, that is the easiest way for you to know that if you die at this very second, whether you are going to heaven, if you love your neighbor. And therefore, if in some way or another you show lack of love for your neighbor, because you're impatient, because you're unkind, because you think of bad things about your neighbor, because you do not help them when you see them in need, you do not guide them to go to heaven, you do not even take care of their physical needs when that is easier than taking care of their spiritual needs, then that's a sign you do not love your neighbor, and therefore you do not have the wisdom that is necessary to grow in the spiritual life. So it is going to be easier for you to grow in wisdom if you have memorized the teachings of Christ. How can you grow in wisdom about a topic that you do not know? If you do not have the knowledge of the command of Christ, how can you grow in wisdom? Impossible. Because wisdom is when you use your mind to keep on thinking and thinking and thinking and thinking of the things that are in your memory. How can you think deeper and deeper into something that is not in your mind, that is not in your memory? That's the reason why Benedict tells us to memorize certain psalms, so you can pray it anytime and meditate on it. That's why he says you have to memorize the chapters on humility, the chapters on obedience, even the proverb. And so all you have to do is ask yourself, have you memorized those chapters of the Holy Rule that Saint Benedict has required? If the answer is yes, then it is possible for you to grow in wisdom. But if the answer is you have not memorized them, then it is impossible for you to grow in wisdom. And as Saint Thomas says, if even just for a moment, a second, a minute, you do not grow in wisdom, you lose whatever you have learned in the past. You regress, you deteriorate, you forget the little that you have learned from the past. Now this lesson is very important, as shown to us in the Gospel for today. The apostles were constantly growing in wisdom, and by obeying, they grow in grace. Now Philip was a person who was living in the same place as Peter and Andrew. So they knew each other and they were learning at the same rate with Jesus Christ. They were learning their lessons. Nathanael was not yet part of the disciples of Christ, not yet. He knows nothing yet from Christ. But Nathanael was a man who was always waiting for the coming of Jesus Christ. Waiting, like all the Jews. But unlike the Pharisees and the scribes, he knew how to wait. He knew the command of Christ, of God, to repent. And he was repenting. Unlike the Pharisees, they knew they're supposed to wait for Christ by repenting, but they were not repenting. So like us, we are here in the monastery primarily to repent so that we can take away our past sins, all our past sins. And by now you should know how to repent. We have discussed it many times before. But if you know how to repent, but you are not, then you are just like the Pharisees. If Christ comes, you will not recognize him as God, and therefore you cannot be saved. Like the Pharisees, you might see Christ as man, but like Saint Thomas says, if you see Christ only as a man, you could go to hell. You have to see him as a God. And so the Pharisees were not learning. They were not growing in wisdom and in grace. So they end up crucifying Christ. The same thing will happen to you. If you do not grow in grace and in wisdom, Saint Paul says you will just end up crucifying Christ. Now, Nathanael was described as an Israelite with no guile. He had no sins. His past sins were all forgiven because he had learned, he had wisdom from the teachings of the Old Testament, which is repentance, but a repentance that could not forgive sins. You need the repentance of Christ to have your sins forgiven. So Nathanael was repenting according to the Old Testament, but it is the kind of repentance that could not forgive the sins. So when he was told by Christ that I saw you under the fig tree talking with Philip, the symbolism of the fig tree is your sins are not yet forgiven, even if you have repented in the Old Testament way. So we have to be very sure that our repentance here in the monastery is the repentance of Christ of the New Testament, because that is what forgives our past sin. The repentance of the Old Testament cannot forgive sin. So when Christ told Nathanael, I saw you under the fig tree is the state that your sins are not yet forgiven, even if you have repented. And so Adam and Eve, when they first sinned, the first thing they did was to wear fig leaves, the leaves of a fig tree, because they realized that they were still in the state of sin. And so Nathanael, even if he had repented of his past sins, because his repentance was Old Testament, was still in the state of sin. Nathanael and Philip, by talking under the fig tree, showed they were still in the state of sin. Their sins had not been forgiven, though Nathanael had no guile. He did not have any serious sins. And what was wrong with them? Because their wisdom was not yet complete. They had the wisdom of the Old Testament, and Nathanael knew more Old Testament than Philip. Because Philip said something that was wrong. He said, we have seen Christ, who was a son of man. Now that was wrong, because Christ was not only the son of man, but the son of God. And when Nathanael made a comment, because Philip says, the man from Nazareth, the remark of Nathanael was better, showed he knew more than Philip, who was converting him. Because Philip said, the man from Nazareth, that Christ was from Nazareth, and that was wrong, because Christ was from Bethlehem. And so Nathanael, who was being converted by Philip, corrected Philip, who was converting him, which shows that Nathanael knew more than Philip. So Nathanael said, "Can any good come out of Nazareth?" Because he knew very well his Old Testament, and he knew that the Messiah was not going to come from Nazareth. He knew, unlike Philip, that the Messiah was going to come from Bethlehem. So you see, very little things, but it shows whether you are growing in wisdom and in grace. And so when Christ told Nathanael, Nathanael was waiting for a proof that Jesus Christ was the Messiah. And the proof given by Philip was wrong. So Nathanael was waiting until Christ says, "I saw you when you were under the fig tree." Now, there was nothing very special about Nathanael being under a fig tree. But Nathanael knew very well what Christ meant. Christ was saying, "Nathanael, I still know the sins that are in your soul." And Nathanael, knowing his Old Testament, knew that only God can know your sins. Of course, other men can know your sins if they have seen you committing sin. But unless anybody knows it, only God alone can know your sin. And so Nathanael says, "You are truly the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." Still wrong. Notice that his description of Christ was, "You are the Son of God," correct, but "You are the King of Israel," wrong, just like Philip. And so Christ told Nathanael what was wrong with him. "You have not grown in wisdom and in grace." See? Superiors are just watching you to see the state of your soul. And how do we do that? Just by seeing if every day you grow in wisdom and in grace. If we see you after 40 years of our community's history, looking exactly the way you looked like 40 years ago, that is a very bad sign. And if we have taught you something last month, and you are not still doing it, and you're still ignorant of what had been taught to you last month, that is a very bad sign. You are not growing in wisdom and in grace. And so Christ tells Nathanael, "Well, Nathanael, you are just seeing my power as God, like knowing your sins when you were under the fig tree. Grow in wisdom and in grace, and you are going to see greater things that will show you precisely I am God, and that you are going to be saved. You are going to see greater things like seeing angels ascending Theologians also say that if you see your guardian angels, which in the history many of our young saints have seen, physically they have seen their guardian angel, that's a good sign. Because to know your guardian angel is growing in grace and wisdom. And so the Mass for today, Christ continues to tell us and tells Philip, "Well, Philip, you know many things more than Nathaniel knows more than Philip. You know more than the one trying to convert you. Maybe you know more than your senior, but that's not enough. It's not enough. Grow more in grace and wisdom so you can see greater things." In the name of the Father,